मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स सी वी हैव स्टार्टेड द लेसन दैट इज कोल एंड पेट्रोलियम एंड सो मेनी पॉइंट्स वी हैव डिस्कस बिफोर वी लर्न बिफोर सो इन दिस लेसन अवर लास्ट पॉइंट इट इज देयर दैट इज सम लिमिटेड नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज ओके सो बिफोर टू स्टार्ट दिस लेसन वॉट वी लर्न सो वॉट वी नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज देन क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज दैट इज एग्जॉस्टिबल इन एग्जॉस्टिबल नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज एंड इन एग्जॉस्टिबल नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज वी हैव लर्न अबाउट कोल एंड पेट्रोलियम ओके सो दिस कोल हाउ टू गेट कोल एंड सब प्रोडक्ट ऑफ कोल ओके एंड पेट्रोलियम हाउ पेट्रोलियम वी गेट सो दैट ऑल द प्रोसेस एवरीथिंग वी लर्न बिफोर So now, these some limited natural resources means what? Those natural resources are in a limited quantity. That natural resources are known as a limited natural resources. Or you learn before also that exhaustible natural resources. Okay, means these natural resources are going to be exhaust. It will be finished after some years. Why? Because day by day the population is increasing, okay, and we are using in a lot amount of this natural resources for our daily purpose. So it is going to be finished. So some ways, some rules we have to follow for that, okay. So today we will discuss about the limitation of the fossil fuels. Now fossil fuels means one that coal and petroleum we learn that why it is known as a fossil fuels because this coal and petroleum we get from the organism okay means plants and animal we get from organic compounds this coal and petroleum and it take a millions of years to form this coal and petroleum so it is known as a fossil fuels so which are the limitations of fossil fuels Means some limitations are there. So first one is limited availability. Okay. Now see why it is in a limited quantity. As you know that it take a millions of years to form, and we are using it regularly. So it is going to be finished. So it is in a limited quantity. Okay. So we have to use it properly. And the next one it is it causes air pollution. Now see, whenever the fossil fuels burns, it releases a harmful gases, and because of these gases, the air pollution causes, and some gases are very harmful for us. So see, burning of fossil fuels produce gases like carbon dioxide. See, produce gases like carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide. As you know that this coal and petroleum, not carbon, is present in a lot of amounts, and sulfur is also present. And because of that, these harmful gases release while burning these fossil fuels. So, which gases release while burning? See, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and sulfur dioxide. See, you have heard that is a acid rain. Okay, acid rain. How it is? See. Sulfur dioxide produced by burning of the fossil fuels combined with rain water to form a sulfuric acid. See, sulfur when the sulfur dioxide gas produced by burning these fossil fuels, so that sulfur dioxide gas is combined with a rain water. Okay, and whenever it combined with rain water, it form a sulfuric acid. And that rain water is known as a that rain is known as a acid rain, and it is harmful for plants, animals as well as for us also. Okay, so it is known as a acid rain, and this cause because of a burning of fossil fuels. Okay, now see here, carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas. Now greenhouse gases now which are. Gases are known as a greenhouse gases that you know already. See, carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas which lead to increase in temperature of our earth. Now see, global warming day by day it is increasing. Why? Because it is increasing the percentage of carbon dioxide. Okay, now carbon dioxide percent will increase, then it increase temperature also, and because of that the global warming also increasing. Okay, now how to conserve these fossil fuels? Now we know that these fossil fuels, it take a thousand or millions of years to form. Okay, so we have to use it in a proper way. We have to conserve it. And how to conserve these fossil fuels, that we will see. See, the first one, reduce the use of the fossil fuels. Now reduce the use. See, whenever it is necessary, that time only you use. Now see, petrol, diesel, where it is used, that is used in a vehicle. Okay, so whenever it is really it is necessary, that time only we have to use our vehicle. For a small distance, short distance, avoid using vehicles, then you can conserve the petrol and diesel. Okay, and see, sometimes we have to use the public transport also. Then see, we should encourage the use of renewable sources, energy like green energy and solar energy. See, now renewable sources, we know that is wind energy, solar energy. So we have to encourage the people, they should use the solar energy. See, we are using for the cooking purpose natural gas. Okay, but now solar cookers, it is also working very properly, they work proper. So wind energy. Now see, PCRA. Now PCRA means what? Petroleum Conservation Research Association. See, this is very important. This is the short form of this PCRA, Petroleum Conservation Research Association. So they have decided some rules, and that rules if we will follow, then we can reduce the petrol and diesel use. Okay, so what they have suggested to us, to drive vehicles safely, means in a constant speed. Okay, if we will drive vehicles constant speed and smoothly, we can conserve the diesel and petrol. Or some again and again, if we will apply the brake, then what the energy, that fuel is converted into energy, that so it need a more amount of petrol and diesel. So with constant speed we have to drive. Then regular maintenance of our vehicle is also important. If we see, after a 6 month we just have to check our vehicle. If we regularly take the maintenance of our vehicle, then it use less amount of fuel. Okay, and if we will not see for that, then it use a more amount of fuel. So such rules they have decided. If we will follow this rule, then we can conserve the fossil fuels. Okay, so this is our last one. It is there in your textbook. Okay, NCERT textbook. That topic name is some limited natural resources. So this today our lesson is completed. That is coal and petroleum. It take a lot of time to complete, and so many new points are there for you. So read this lesson carefully. Read at today at least twice. You read lesson. If you have any doubt related to any point, you just contact to me. Okay. And after this lecture, what you have to do? Solve worksheet. See worksheet. Already I have given you coal and petroleum. Take worksheet and try to write all question and answers. If any answer you will not get, you just contact to me. Now next period we will start our new lesson. So today I will stop here. Thank you.